So what if Jesus was saying over here, to whom was he speaking to? He looked at his disciples. He just chose those disciples. I mean, and he lifted up his eyes on who? His disciples. And said, blessed be you, or blessed poor.
Oh my God, I just got a revelation.
See, Jesus is bringing the truth to who they are. Jesus is about to reveal to them who they truly are. He picked these 12 disciples. He stayed praying all night long. He selected the disciples. He did miracles with them. Then he looked at them and said, blessed poor one. How about blessed fallen one?
Blessed
fallen one. Then he said, for yours is the kingdom of God. Ooh, I get this book for all of
them. Yes.
You see, so he's talking to the fallen. Who's the fallen one? The human race is the fallen one. Who Christ came to save? And the word say, again, I hate when they have taken that word say. Where's my pen over here? Because they have taken the word save, right? And I always ask, save from what? Save from what?
Yes,
it was hell.
Well, the way they
told us. Huh? Like a joke. Say from what? Oh, Jesus came to save us. Save me from what? Let them tell you hell. Isn't it true? When the word save, when you look at the translation, this means whole. So what Jesus came to do? To bring what?
To make me whole.
But the translation of save, we use the save from something, so we apply it to a what? Hell. When he came to make us what? Complete. To redeem us. To redeem us from what? From falling. Yes?
Yes.
So, when you look at it that way, and he did to his own disciples and say, blessed be you poor, fallen ones. For you is the kingdom of God. That instantly showed what? Oh my God. Look what the miracle before that statement. Look what it says. Unclean spirit. And they that were vexed with what? Unclean spirit. What is an unclean spirit? What is an incomplete principle. Principality. Remember we talked last week on principalities and power? And the first principle is the first rank. And he lifted his arms up and said, blessed be you poor, for you is the kingdom of God. Then you might question, what about the next one? Blessed are you that what? Hunger now, for you shall be what? Filled. Then blessed are you that hunger now, for you shall be filled. They say, blessed are you that weep now, for you shall laugh. And blessed are you when men shall hate you, and when they shall separate you from the company and shall reproach you, and cast out your name as evil for the Son of Man's sake. Son of Man's sake. Who's man? We all are. And we're born out of man. We come from man. We come from Adam. Man. Now, I take this over here. And I take up to Genesis, chapter 3. What? Curse the ground. For thy sake, in sorrow shalt thou what? Eat all the days of thy life. So who's hungry? When Jesus talked to who was hungry?
Mankind.
So we say, blessed are you poor, for you are the kingdom of God. Blessed are you that hunger now. Who? The one that was hungry. Because the ground is cursed now, for whose sake? See, man was not the one cursed. He was who?
The ground.
So, thou shalt not eat of it. Cursed is the ground for thy sake. So if you cannot eat, who's hungry? We are. And what was the other one? Thou shalt not eat, cursed be the ground of sorrow, to show thou eat all the days of thy life. Thorns also and thistle shall they bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the earth of the field. In the what?
In the sweat.
Sweat of thy face shalt thou eat bread till thou return unto the ground, for out of it wast thou taken, for dust thou art, and unto dust shalt thou return. Now, can you see what Jesus was talking? He wasn't talking to just the group of people. He was talking to who? Mankind, humanity. Now you say, blessed are you, what, fallen one? For you as the kingdom of God. Blessed are you that the earth have been cursed for you and hunger now. What does he say? For you shall be what? Filled. Blessed are you that weep. Tell me that you're not weeping because you got to work. Who doesn't weep? Blessed are they that weep now, for they shall laugh. Blessed are you when man shall hate you, and when they shall separate you from the company, and shall reproach you, and cast you out, your name as evil. What's going to happen to those disciples? They're going to be cast out from what? From the synagogue. Why? Because they're going to be preaching here now a totally different message that had nothing to do. The message that they're going to preach now is the message of what? Of wholeness. Wholeness. Forget that there. Boom. This is the message now. 1S or 2S?
2S.
That's what we've got to be preaching now. What?
Wholeness.
Wholeness.
Because now that they've been separated, by me saying this on TV now on the internet, I might be what?
Evil.
I might be just be cast out your name as evil for the Son of Man's sake. And I'm doing it for the what? For the man's sake. Amen?
Amen.
So when we continue to read, rejoice you in that day and live for joy. So when you think that you've been what? Betrothed down, smashed down? Rejoice. Amen. And live for joy. For behold, your reward is great in heaven. For in the like manner did their fathers unto the prophets. What did they give to the prophets? Every time the prophet brought the good news, they killed him. And I can show you in the Old Testament book of Ezekiel, when it says the new covenant that he will make, he will bring a new spirit, a new heart, a new way of doing things. But because you're going to leave the old thing, what's going to happen to you? You're going to be abused, misused, and what? Maybe crucified. For the message of what? Of wholeness, complete salvation.